Alright, so we're here at Broome Caravan Park. We're here for 5 nights. There's not too much here at the caravan park. There's no playground for the kids, which is a bit of a downfall. It's got a beautiful, lovely pool. I'll swing you around and show you that now. So
we've got a lap pool here if you want to swim laps, which is also attached to a bigger pool over the back. So
it's freezing cold. The park itself is nice. There's no sort of entertainment here on the weekends. The facilities are okay. The staff here are not too bad. The office staff, when you check in, well, I wouldn't even say polite. They're pretty rude. We were basically told can't check in before 12, which is all well and good. So Jen decided to sit out the front because we were about half an hour early or so. Other people started arriving, so they then locked the door. And then basically we're just rude all throughout. So and then as we were checking in, basically told if you go more than 8Ks, you're kicked out of the park. If your kids jump off the rocks, you're kicked out of the park. If your kids are in the garden beds, you're kicked out of the park. If they're climbing on rocks, you're kicked out of the park. So, but besides that, it was actually not too bad of a stay. Three Bells ended up joining us on Monday and parking right behind us. So it's a massive park. There's the van there and the patrol, of course. So yeah, it's a good stay. It's close to Cable Beach. It's about, I don't know, 5 minute drive to Cable Beach and about the same into town. So the location's pretty good and it's pretty much as soon as you come into Broome. It's your first caravan park on the left. So yeah, it's not a too bad of a stay. I can't comment on any other caravan parks. However, Cable Beach was booked out well in advance and this was the only caravan park we could get into. But in saying that, this is booked out solid. So yeah, stays all right, facilities are all right, pool's amazing but cold. Yeah, quick rundown. So tonight we've just headed out to the speedway here in Broome. It's about 100 meter walk from the caravan park, which is why we decided to come. And upon entering, the lady at the gate said you get half price entry if you're from the caravan park. So it only ended up costing us $25 for the family.
Instead of 50.
So that was winning. So now we have beer money. So we're just chilling here, having a few beers. That's Claire, wants to say hello. She's already eating her lunch, or dinner I should say. That's the speedway. Yeah, nice little bar area. So, no BYO. You can bring your car here and park around the fence, set up your chairs and stuff. Or there is a nice area here under the cover where the bar area is.
For us walk-ins.
I got beer and spirits here. $4 for mid-strength, $5 for heavies, which is pretty reasonable. That will show you a little bit of the action and check it out if you're in Broome.
Thank you. Bit of a rainy day in Broome today. Looks nice and sunny now though. This morning was a bit rainy, so we decided to come down to the museum. It was $12 per adult. Kids under 16 were free. They'd been given a nice little quiz to do while they're walking around. So Claire has to tick off lots of things, and Ruby has to do level 2.
Quiz 2.
Which is gotta find some things and do some reading. So we're gonna walk around. There's lots about the pearling here and World War II. So
Look.
You found one. Excellent. More big dive suits.
Wait, did.
Shells made into things like knives and forks and buttons. The ships they used to go out on for weeks on end. I think I should do before. The big diving suit. How much does the dive suit weigh?
55.
How much are the boots?
616.
That's very heavy.
We calculated, like, with a man in, it's about 130 kilograms.
Yeah.
And someone is pulling them up.
That's right.
Crazy.
So what else have you learnt?
Life was hard back then.
Life was hard? Yeah. What else? Did you enjoy doing the quiz? The quiz and you got your little prize. Good job.
So
did you do anything exciting from that? Do you remember?
We watched a movie.
How was your excursion?
Okay. Hopefully now we can go home and play.
Schoolwork is done, has it?
Yeah. Hey, that's another one of your things. Maybe this is what they meant, so.
This is the old sailmaker's shed. Used to be Sea Bag and Hamley's to making all the sails for all of the ships for the pearling. So they restored it back in 2008 to get it all back to its current form of glory so everyone can enjoy it. Bit of history on how they made the sails. Knot tying exercise, reef knots, half hitches, whatever you can practice, and just the history of the area and how many people he had working for him and all that sort of stuff. Very interesting.
Alright, the Dinosaur Coast, the Dampier Peninsula, so they've got 20 different types of tracks from four main groups of dinosaurs. The theropods, the sauropods, the theriophrans, and the orthonopods. So at very low tide, you can see these tracks down on the point, which we're going to go do on Wednesday. But 130 million years ago, they were roaming these shores. Did you have fun at the museum?
Hey.
What did you learn? Yeah, what's that? That's how they dive underwater. What are they diving for?
I'm confused.
They're
diving for shells.
Pearl shells. And what else did you learn?
Well, we learned to get these stuff.
Ah, you had to search for all that stuff. Good job. All right, you're gonna weigh yourselves? Whoa. That was a good morning of learning things, and the girls enjoyed themselves with their quiz. So if you're around Broome, definitely worth a little look-see and learn the history of all the pearling around here.
We're here at Gantheaume Point. So just having a look around, there's a lighthouse here. Great view, little sandstone stuff, rocks. You're fishing off the rocks.
Crystal clear that water.
Crystal clear water.
Yeah,
cars on the beach down there. We're gonna have a look over there too. Might even have a snorkel there. Here at Gantheaume Point, there's a couple of dinosaur trails as well. Some of them you can only see at low tide, and then this one they've taken molds of, I think, and placed it at the top here. So here's some real dinosaur feet. There's a comparison. Put your foot next to it, Claire. There's another one. There's Ruby's feet. Pretty cool.
Down this torrentious of rocks on low tide so we could find dinosaur footprints.
We found one.
Can you take it over to Dave to show?
Okay.
Dave,
you go show them.
There we have the dinosaur footprint. There's Ruby's foot next to it. Down here on the rocks.
Dad, can you clean that, baby?
There's foot. Kids are loving trying to find these dinosaur footprints down here. Beautiful cliffs.
Are you on a YouTube channel?
Yeah.
Hi.
Little Gracie.
There's another footprint there in the water. It's not quite low tide, about 6 minutes, but I don't think it's going to go out. And this is why they say it's going to be low, low tide to see these footprints. So, there it is there. Yeah. Just here at Cable Beach. Watching the sunset this afternoon. So, got the kids
playing in the sand. Camels walking on the beach there in the distance. Jen, relaxing. Got three bells here as well with us. Having a beer and some nibblies. And just gonna watch the sunset.
right, we are all hooked up in Broome, ready to go down the coast, and that's our final goodbye to the bells.
And I'm hugs. One of the bells.
Mm-hmm. Hugs. All the cuddles. All the cuddles. All the cuddles. Final goodbye.
Mum and Dad.
See you later.
Happy travels.
Yeah,
happy birthday.
Keep in touch.
Let
us know how it all goes. Travels.
See ya.
Lovely to meet you. Yes. Claire's already made me promise that we're going to go to the Sunshine Coast in a year.
Yes.
Come ride the horses.
Yeah, we want to do Queensland. So.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll come to Queensland.
Ride the horses.
Come into Queensland.
You'll be able to stay with all of us down in Brisbane.
Yeah.
On the sunny coast.
So that was a bit of a sad goodbye, but we've left Broome and we're heading down to Barnhill Station. Broome was fun, relaxing, not a heap to do there. Lots of beach, well, a couple of beach days and a couple of exploring days, a museum day. But otherwise it was just sitting around having a holiday.
Enjoying people's company.
Enjoying people's company, that's right. The last time we got to see the bells, so we just hung out with them for a bit.
Yeah.
They had some family come up, it was Harry's birthday.
Like Jen said, there's not too much to do. I'd personally stay 3 nights if you've got the choice. That'll give you time to do everything, do a bit of a beach day and a bit of exploring and whatnot.
That'll get you everything.
Yeah, 3 or 4 nights. We stayed 6. Depends what you're doing. Like, we used it to catch up school. What else do we do? Just sort of clean the van and
clean
car
the van.
And that sort of stuff, and all the beach driving and off-roading and
some
whatnot.
Editing.
So yeah, it depends on what you've got planned. If you want a couple of down days just to chill, stay more. But if you've got a bit of a timeline, 3 nights will get you done.
Get you done. Yeah.
So yeah.
Off to Barnhill Station, and then heading down the coast towards Perth. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching.